Okay, it's time to wrangle. On the desk here with me is Sky News host Liz Storer. And in Melbourne, of course, we're joined as ever by columnist and broadcaster Justin Smith. Thanks both for joining me. I've got to get your thoughts about this. Let's have a look at the Prime Minister yesterday.
The idea that we're... Have you got Tourette's or something? Sit there, babble, babble, babble.
Order.
I withdraw, Mr. Speaker. I withdraw.
Yeah.
I withdraw. I withdraw and apologise.
He withdrew and apologised. Then he went back later, Justin, and made a big formal apology. Is this a lot of kerfuffle over nothing? Can't we just go on?
Well, I tell you who knew it was wrong, which is Richard Marles. If you look at Richard in the background, the second that the comment was made, I think he was well and truly understanding of what was happening. I'm not going to pretend to be offended by it. There may be some that were, but he also apologised for it straight away. So, I mean, can we not... You know, it's not like he tried to defend it down the track. So, look, I'm with you. It's a bit of the argy-bargy inside Parliament. But they've also got to be held to a higher standard as well. We'd all agree with that.
But what about... Is it just out of hand, Liz? Can we say someone's blind to some issue or deaf to some issue? Or do we just have to censor our language at every step?
It's so out of hand. And, look, the opposition should have fired back that as a Prime Minister with a speech impediment, he was... glass houses, mate.
Say it, spray it.
Exactly. And then today we've got Patricia Karvelas on the ABC having to apologise for referring to a piece of policy as schizophrenic. Yep. How is that not a very relevant and applicable, in terms of the policy that they were talking about, adjective for that kind of speech?
It has reached
a utterly ridiculous level. Everyone's playing the PC game. I think the more people who just say, oh, look, I obviously wasn't mocking anyone, I didn't mean it that way.
It's a figure of speech. It's a lively language. Yeah.
Yep.
All right, let's get to your neck of the woods, Justin, and talk about the Lord Mayoral contest where our good mate and lovable lefty Nick Rees is running for Lord Mayor. He wants to now give tax breaks so companies can take their staff or others to lunch in the city. They bring back the long lunch at taxpayers' expense to rejuvenate your city. It's going nowhere, right?
Now, Chris, just before you go any further, you will have to explain to the kids at home what a long lunch is. This goes way back, doesn't it? When they go, because, mate, I've got to tell you, those were the days, weren't they? Hey, the old tax-deductible lunch, fantastic. But let's just get this into perspective here. And bless Nick Rees for throwing up this idea. What this calls for is, if he actually becomes the Lord Mayor again when the election's done, he's then got to go to the federal government and tell them to put this into place for him. So the chances of this happening, it's
zero.
All very good sport for us right now. The chances are bugger and all.
Bugger and all. And Nicholas, if anything happens, I want a long lunch, all right? And I want to choose where we go.
We're going to take us out of lunch.
Exactly. Do the wrangle over lunch. Now, just while we're on Nicholas Rees, let's look at, he's doing a lot on social media. He's quite the hip campaigner. Have a look at this.
Just sliding into your feed with the news that I'm building 28 new parks in the city of Melbourne, just like this one.
Sliding into your feet, mate, give it a rest.
I'm just not one of those people who appreciates all the cringe from politicians. A lot of them are doing these cutesy things now, and I'm just like, I just want to see a leader. Can you lead? Do you have good policies? Can you deliver on your promises? Like, you're literally
like
running
Donald Trump
on
dancing.
Fringe benefits tax reform, which we all know is in the jurisdiction of the feds. That's all I want to know. So this cutesy kind of thing, I know it's all the rage nowadays, but I think the vast majority of people just want to see a leader.
Well, I think if we know that all the politicians are going to slide down that particular slide, we'll just get some oxy gear and we'll weld up the bottom end.
I only vote for people on monkey bars.
We'll just leave them in there.